Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to welcome you all to this special meeting of the Village Board, held this the 21st day of June at 7 a.m. in the North Exhibit Hall at the Tinley Park Convention Center. If you'd join me, let us all rise and do the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. At this time, I would like to ask the clerk to call the roll.
Mr. Mayor, members of the board, Tinley Park Village Special Board Meeting, June 21st, 2016, on roll call. Trustee Maher.
Here.
Trustee Grady.
Here.
Trustee Pinito.
Here.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Present.
Trustee Junker.
Present.
Trustee Suggs.
Here.
Mayor Seaman.
Here. Thank you. We have a quorum. This time I'd like to ask for a motion of approval of the agenda. May I have such a motion?
So moved.
A second?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Item number two, approval of the minutes of the special village board meetings held on June 7th, 2016 at 6:30 p.m. and at 8 o'clock p.m. May I have such a motion?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
All in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Item number three, I would like to ask for a motion to approve the consent agenda. May I have such a motion?
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
Thank you. Mr. Clerk.
Item three, consider approval of the following consent agenda items. A, consider request for a block party permit on Saturday, July 16th, 2016 at 8525 through 8545 West 162nd Place from noon to 10 p.m. B, consider request for a block party permit on Saturday, July 23rd, 2016 at 9006 through 9131 Walnut Lane from 2:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. C, consider request for MNM RC to conduct a raffle on August 21st, 2016 with the winners drawn that day at the American Legion. D, request from the National Association of Town Watch, NATW, to proclaim Tuesday, August 2nd, 2016 as the 33rd annual National Night Out in the Village of Tinley Park. And E, payment of outstanding bills in the amount of $2,346,368.58 as listed on the vendor board approval report dated June 10th and June 17th, 2016.
It's been moved and seconded. Would we consider
it? Want a roll call?
At this time, I would like to ask the clerk for the roll.
Item three, then, on roll call. Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Pinito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yay.
Trustee Junker.
Yay.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Thank you. At this time, I would like to have a couple of presentations. We're fortunate enough to be the host committee for the Tinley Park Lady Bulldogs, as well as the Tinley Park Bulldogs, each winning division lacrosse at the Invitational that was conducted on the 21st and 22nd of May at in Washington, Illinois. So I'm going to first of all start this asking, because ladies are first, asking the coach, Pat Sandera, to come up and to tell us a little bit about the event before we present the certificates. Pat?
Is this on? Yeah, okay, good. Can never tell. On the third weekend in, I think it was the third weekend in May, a group of 20 young ladies went down to the Washington Invitational to compete in a tournament that we had come really, really close to making the championship game the year before. And they pretty much dominated all competition down there. We went with 20 girls, and 18 of them scored goals while we were down there. So that shows the teamwork that the girls and all the hard work that they had put in through the season, it finally paid off for them. So they were really impressive, and they had the coolest uniforms there, too. So that's about it. It's been 2 years of hard work to get the ladies to where they were. 2 years ago, when I was asked to coach a team, we were right on the edge of not being able to do it, and it went from being able to do it to going down there and representing Tinley Park, and everyone should be proud of them for the way they conducted themselves and played down there as a team.
Absolutely. Congratulations. Get up for pictures or whatever.
Dave, you'll have to turn that on.
Maya and Skylar Bruette, the twins, original Bulldogs.
Sophia DeSantis. Madison Drebbing. Caitlin Drizinga. Drizga, I'm sorry. Great job. Alexis Gatos. Becca Hallman. Jade Hamilton, except we've got her name. Okay, let's hear it for Jade. Tatum Hammerschmidt. Paige Knight. Jessica Manson. Allison Alwadi. Blade.
You got the wrong uniform.
That's really for a sister, by the way.
Well, that's a family. Okay.
Chloe Papen.
No brother.
Bella Bellini.
Bella.
Camden Pullen. Lindsay Riley. Nicole Sandera. Okay. Manisa Shams. Natalie Smith. Neve Tomey. And coach Michelle Hallman.
Congratulations. That was a great job. Say, we want to thank all of the parents, the kids that basically spent so much time working to make this a winning season. We're proud of you. We're glad you're part of Tinley Park, and congratulations again. Thanks so very much. Now we've got the boys. Would Coach George Montalvo come up and tell us a little bit about the season and the team?
Those are huge trophies.
All right, so this was for the boys' U9 lacrosse team, which is basically first to third graders. This is our third year going to the Washington Invitational. The past 3 years, we won zero games. We did not win any games out there. This year, we not only won all five games, we scored 37 goals. We only allowed 17, which was a point differential of 20 points, which was really good. The boys dominated out there. We had nine first-year players. So we had three second-year players and three third-year players. They all got together and worked together as a team. We have a great group of coaches. We have five great assistant coaches and an awesome team mom. Everyone put a lot of effort into making this a successful season for Tinley Park.
Thank you, Coach. Come on up here. We'll call the boys up. That's a beauty. Wow. Fabulous. Very nice. Well, we'll have competing trophies here. Alexander Bartling.
Liz Alex coming here with the program.
Congratulations. Troy Culbertson.
Troy's first year. Great job, Troy.
Congratulations. Great job. Luke Degner.
Okay. This is Luke's first year as well. How about
Luke? Tyler Drexel. Great job. Owen Earhart. Great job. Elijah Hoekstra. Excellent. Great job. Lex Malawa. Great job. Congratulations. Sean McHugh. Great job. Thomas Riley. Tiger Ringer. All right.
Great runs up there.
David Rosner. Congratulations. Nolan Rosner. Okay, we've got Captain Mike Battles. Very good. Congratulations. Coach Adam Culbertson. I was with him last night. Oh, another birthday. Congratulations. Coach Ron Degner. Okay. Coach Bill Dregsda. Oh, sorry about that.
Missed you earlier.
We're a big family.
Yeah.
At least you're not going home empty.
Alexander Montalvo.
Very good. Participation. Absolutely.
And of course, the head coach, George Montalvo. Congratulations. Captain Josh Alade. Yeah. Coach Markalade.
Yeah.
It's clear that it's a family affair, right? Great. Coach Dave Rosner. Thanks again. Congratulations. Coach Steve Rosner. Big family, right? Coach Patrick Sandera. A little mixed up. And Coach Rick Dorado. Picture would be great. Whatever, however, you can fit everybody in this. I don't know if the boys want to.
We're going to do it.
Absolutely.
Perfect.
Absolutely. Whatever you guys want.
Another one for the West Coast.
You know, we're spending a lot of time on this tonight, but really it's important that we recognize the efforts that have been done by both the kids and the parents and the coaches. So to spend this time doing this is an excellent investment, in my opinion.
Whatever you want.
That's nice.
It's what you do when you're a sports parent. Taking pictures every chance you get.
Is that a voice of experience?
Yeah.
Well, good for you.
That's what I did last weekend. That's what I'll do next weekend.
Hey, let's do the girls.
Yeah.
The other, then we'll leave. You guys stay there. Stay there.
Kevin's going to get baptism by fire.
No, there was a blurb that one of the 7,000 members that said they made comments for space for
Pretty
sure that's what
they have a complaint about the space, which we didn't know until just now.
Oh.
But we're about to find out. They're going to come first.
I think that, they're piece of that. Put it on the agenda and feel this. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's
true. You can't.
Okay, girls only, right?
I don't know what. I don't know if they're going to ask for a vote. Maybe they are.
Maybe they don't get two trophies.
Well, the time frame is probably limited if they're trying to get something like a. What is it, a condom or something?
I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you'd be in the picture?
No.
Thanks so much.
And congratulations once again.
Yeah, you don't want to see what's going to happen next. Yeah.
Good job, girls.
Good job, girls.
That was wonderful.
No, I think that's fun.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Take care, guys.
I can't imagine that you don't want to spend the evening here with us, but.
So this was the first tournament. I was at that tournament in Washington.
So your kid plays lacrosse?
Yeah.
That wasn't even around when my kids were growing up. I mean, it started in, at least in Chicago, out in the western suburbs.
Yeah.
At least as far as I
north
know.
North and west, yeah.
But that was after my kids were out.
I think Berkeley's only had it for like 3 years. So the guy who was running.
Item number 6. At this time, I would like to ask for a
Motion to appoint Trustee Brian Yonker to serve as Mayor Pro Tem for the 2016-2017 fiscal year. May I have such a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. I'd like to thank Brian for accepting the assignment. Thank you, sir. And I'd also like to thank Brian Maher for having served this past year as pro tem. It's one of those thankless, no-pay jobs that basically helps the mayor's office be in places that he can't. And so I'm very grateful. And
been my pleasure.
Thank you. Thanks so much, Brian. Item number 7, consider appointment of Kevin Suggs as chairperson to the Budget Audit and Administration Committee. May I have a concurring motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
And a second. It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Consider appointments for the following commission committees for the upcoming year. May I have a concurring motion, please?
But no.
So moved.
And a second.
Second.
I would like to make one clarification here on the Main Street Commission. Beth Fahey has agreed to chair. So if there are no objections, I would like to make that part of this as well.
Not here.
All right, with the maker and the second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Wow.
Staff appointments. That. Item number 9, I would like to ask for a concurring motion to the appointment of the staff as listed in item 9 on your agenda for the upcoming fiscal year. May I have such a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying
Mr. Mayor, before I say, it's been a year since we asked for an RFQ for the engineering firm.
And, yes.
Could we get that? I mean, it's been actually over a year since we've asked for an RFQ for professional services, just to get to see what else is out there.
I believe staff has been directed, Dave?
Yeah, we got the direction last week, and we actually placed it on the next Public Works Committee meeting in July for review and approval of that.
Okay.
So does the appointment, at any time during the fiscal year this year of the appointment process, and those RFQs come in and this board finds it that a new firm may take place or take over, is that a problem, or does the current engineers finish the year?
I'll direct that to legal.
Yeah, I can answer that. The nothing would, along with the power to appoint, comes a power to remove that appointment, so you would not be locked in for a year on any such appointment.
All right. So maybe this is a good time to discuss this appointment process, if we might. Mr. Mayor and fellow trustees, I believe that we should continue the status quo of the appointment process for this cycle. But I believe that we desperately need to review this entire appointment process. Village staff has already begun reviewing the organizational structure of the village. And I have asked that the village attorney as well review and suggest some modifications to our appointment system. I don't believe that this process is best fit for this town, specifically some of our staff members.
Yes, I think I think there was general concurrence with that, and council will be giving us some options to exercise.
Appreciate it.
So you got a motion to approve in a second. Is there
any? Okay. If there are any appointments here on this list that any board member would like removed, please, this would be the time to do so.
I just strongly urge the staff to move forward with the RFQ process. Last year we removed the professional services from the appointment, and we actually never reappointed of 15, and here we are in 16. So I just strongly urge that we continue that process to update this board.
Okay, I see we've got somebody that wants to comment.
I do. Traditionally, at least over the past 3 years, and I'll defer to
our de facto village historian, Patrick Ray, on this. I don't know when the last time someone stood up, but I wasn't going to let this appointment cycle go by and sit idly on my hands. I certainly know the last 3 years no one spoke because I read the minutes of all those. They all happened in the first meeting of May. We're now into June. I've waited patiently for this, and now I'm going to have my say. Quite frankly, I'm disappointed that, and I understand time constraints. I know we spent a lot of time with the Bulldogs. Congratulations to them. I wish all these were done individually. I know that's a long throw. But I'll single out one. I oppose Mr. Niemeyer as village manager. I don't think we're getting our money's worth out of this position right now. I think too often he defers to consultants, and the consultants he gets are not that good and disrespectful to the residents of this village. I think for what we pay, and we pay quite a bit, not just to him, but all the people on the staff, we shouldn't have to go to consultants as often as we do. And that's reflecting of high management that, you know, basically the ball goes with him. Now, obviously, most of the times you just roll right through these and you just say all aye and no no's. But I just wanted to say, I don't think the direction of this village is very good right now. And sometimes you have to get rid of the manager, just like in a baseball team. Not necessarily it's all him, but sometimes you have to make a change. And I'd ask that you guys make that change and not consider his appointment. Thank you.
Any other comments? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Item number 10, I would like to ask for a concurring motion of the appointment of Dan Reardon as interim fire chief effective July 1, 2016 through September 30th, 2016. May I have such a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed?
Abstain.
Motion carries. Item number 11, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you, Mayor. This time I move to consider ordinance 2016-0-036 granting a special use permit for John Chatwin of 7-Eleven Inc. for the operation of an automobile service station at 7601 159th Street in the B3 General Business and Commercial Zoning District.
May we have a second, please?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. The applicant, as I stated, John Chatwin of 7-Eleven, is seeking approval for a special use to continue the operation of an existing automobile service station, which includes a convenience store and fuel canopy. He is going to be adding four additional gas dispensers and expansion of the current canopy. The property owner cooperated with staff and eliminated the northeast access at 159th Street, which was considered to be unsafe but legally permitted by IDOT. He's also improving enhanced landscapes. There were some concerns at the Plan Commission, which I'll just address now. Some of the commissioners stated that there was not going to be adequate width of an access lane, which is north of the canopy, which is 22 feet, but it now measures at 26.5, which is meeting our code, our current village code. He wanted to eliminate the exit on 159th Street, which is the right in, right out only. However, IDOT approved as a full access. If the owner erected a sign restricting access, it would not be enforceable. So these were a couple of things that were discussed during the Plan Commission, and it was recommended for approval. This is first reading.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Item number 12, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. I move to consider ordinance number 2016-0-037, granting a special use to Bridget M. Gillis, senior specialist for AT&T on behalf of Live Nation property owner at 19100 Ridgeland Avenue for purposes of operating a personal wireless service facility at the Live Nation Hollywood Casino Music Amphitheater.
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. As I stated, this is for the amphitheater. This is special use for Live Nation to erect antennas at 48 feet to attach to the amphitheater structure, and it's painted to match the structure. This was a unanimous vote as well.
This would constitute
first reading as well.
First reading. It's been moved and seconded. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Chief, didn't we, and this may be a public works slash police question. Didn't we have some repeaters out there or something to enhance the quality of the signals for the, and is this an opportunity to jump on that?
The radio, our radio system, the problem I think is with the Verizon repeaters, because that's what our system's all on, Verizon, and it still is spotty at best.
Yeah, it may be something to work with them to see if there's
this
a way
AT&T.
We can...
This is AT&T at this point, right?
Correct. Yeah.
Well, okay. Very good. Thank you. Item number 13, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. I move to consider adopting ordinance 2016-0-028, granting a special use permit for Blake Brown on behalf of Hilti North America to operate a business involving retail and wholesale, incidental to a principal use.
We have a second, please.
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. Again, this is for Hilti North America, who is seeking approval for the a retail and the wholesale at their warehouse, which is located at, 18475 Thompson Court. It is zoned ORI, and it's within the Hickory Creek Plan Unit Development. Their hours of operation are 7:30 to 4:30. There's only two employees, and their basic business functionality is retail, wholesales, demonstrations, warehousing, et cetera, et cetera. This is up for adoption.
This item is up for adoption. Anybody on the board have any questions about this? Anybody from the audience have any questions about this? Seeing as there are none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Item 13, final approval of ordinance 028. On roll call, Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Pinito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yay.
Trustee Yunker.
Yay.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 14, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. This time I'd ask for consideration to adopt ordinance number 2016-0-031, granting a 16-foot, 6-inch variation for a fence where the front yard setback requires 25 feet at 17600 70th Avenue in the R4 Single Family Residential Zoning District.
May I have a second, please?
Second.
Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Our petitioners, Lawrence and Helen Brown, are requesting a 16-foot, 6-inch variation, as I stated. This is to replace a 6-foot-tall wood fence at the 8-foot, 6-inch setback on the north side of 176th Street. This is going to be replacing... Pardon me, that's not the correct... this is to replace that wood fence. The Zoning Board of Appeals on May 26, 2016, recommended this request for variation.
Okay, this item is up for final adoption. Anybody on the board have any questions? Anybody in the audience care to comment? Seeing as there were none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Item 14 on final for ordinance 031. On roll call, Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Pinito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yes.
Trustee Yunker.
Yes.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 15, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. I move to consider ordinance 2016-0-039, granting variations from the allowable number of signs and total allowable sign area for wall signage for Rodoliac Law at 7711 159th Street within the B3 General Business and Commercial Zoning District.
May I have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. I think I'll let Paula address this a tad for us.
The request was for a variation for number of signs. They requested 3 wall signs where the ordinance allows 1, and a request for area of signs where the ordinance allows 74 and they requested 142. At a vote from 4-2, the Plan Commission approved a revision of the requested variance and approved 2 wall signs rather than 3, and a total area of 70 square feet where 74 is allowed, a variation of 70 square feet. The rationale being that this is a unique architecturally styled building and that visibility from westbound traffic is hindered, and so they allowed or they recommended for approval a sign on the north side and the east side of the building.
Thank you. Thanks, the petitioner's counsel is with us this evening. Are there any comments that you'd like to add?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. For the record, David Sasson, on behalf of the petitioner. We've agreed to that change and actually felt like we amended the petition. So we're in full agreement with this as a common sense approach to resolving this matter. We look forward to doing major, major work on this building for our client, who's a 22-year resident business of the village. So we appreciate all the consideration given by the Zoning Board of Appeals, who really took some time with us. Thank you.
Thank you, David. This item is on for first reading. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item number 16, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. I move to consider ordinance 2016-0-040 granting a 25-foot variation for a fence where the front yard setback requirement is 25 feet at 17004 Odell Avenue in the R4 Single Family Residential District.
May we have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Our petitioners, Kenneth and Sherry Craig, are requesting this 25-foot variation to replace an existing fence with a minimum of a 5-foot open-style wood fence at a zero setback on the north side of 170th Place. This is going, like I said, going to replace an existing fence.
Are the petitioners with us this evening? Are there any comments you'd like to make? Okay, it's all right. The R4 district is particularly challenging, especially if you're on a corner lot, having lived through that myself, so I get it. Any other?
It aligns with the neighbor's fence is basically what you said.
Gotcha.
It aligns with the neighbor's fence is what, yeah. I just like for the record that the ZBA on June 9th did recommend this variation to this board.
Very good. This is for first reading. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item number 17, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Before reading this, I would just like to make a note that there should be a correction to the agenda. I believe this is for adoption and not first reading. Is this the correct ordinance? Right, Laura? Yeah, there was a mistake that was made preparing the agenda. So this is actually for final adoption this evening. This was already read at a board meeting.
Thank you.
Do we need to amend that? Or?
Here's what I would recommend. I do remember doing this at the last one. I would just, in the motion, just since it does say first reading on here, just make the motion to waive
to
first
amend,
reading.
To amend, oh, to waive.
Just make it first. Just ask for to waive first reading, even though it's not, that's what the agenda says. I think that's
you want
better.
Me to waive it first before
yes.
I read the motion?
Yes, just waive it because that's what the agenda says.
I request says. That we waive first reading.
Second concur.
Number 17.
Second concur.
Second.
Brian. Brian seconding.
Brian second. Okay. Oh. Very good.
Yes. All right. So we're good now, Council.
I have for roll call anyway. So.
Yeah, we'll get. But we're getting to the. We had to amend this to be waiver of first reading.
Oh, the writing.
Council has suggested.
Just for the attorney, for the trustee's sake, we actually had it down for roll call, but I see what you're saying. There's a write-up mistake.
Please continue.
Appreciate it. So just for clarification, that there was a mistake on the agenda. This was already read at a board meeting. We made a clarification and we're proceeding forward with our final adoption. So this is ordinance number 2016-0-035, amending the village zoning ordinance for the purpose of updating the village's sign regulations. And a second. Anybody second that?
Yeah, maybe a second for that.
Okay, second. We'll re-second it. Brian.
Now that we're all confused.
We have a motion and a second now for that.
I'm sorry?
Do you have the motion and a second?
Thank you. We're clear. Thank you. So again, this is to revise our sign regulations in the zoning ordinance and addresses inconsistencies and administrative difficulties with the current sign regulations. The first phase of this comprehensive sign update, staff is working on it, which is temporary signs, signs related to auto dealerships, and signs within the legacy district. The proposed text amendment was approved by the Plan Commission on January 7, 2016, and the revisions are as follows. To clarify the maximum sign face for each type of signage, regulate signage in a table by zoning district, change sign face area measurement to boxes, which is the geometry around the sign, update electronic message center requirements, create clear setback line of sight requirements for ground signs, and to create clear letter height requirements for wall signs. I would just add that this is something that I've tasked staff with for months now. I think the Plan Commission did a nice job of critiquing it, and this should allow for a smoother process for any business owner or developer to move forward with for addressing their business in Tinley Park. So I think this is a good start to creating a clear and comprehensive zoning code.
Thank you. Anybody on the board care to comment? Anybody from the public care to comment? Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Item 17, with waiver of first reading, final on ordinance 035, roll call. Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Panito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yes.
Trustee Junker.
Yay.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 18, Trustee Grady.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd ask the board to consider resolution 2016-R021, authorizing an intergovernmental agreement with the member agencies of the Northeastern Illinois Regional Crime Laboratory.
May we have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you, Brian. The proposed intergovernmental agreement with the Northern Illinois Regional Crime Lab will help the village to move to more quickly process information in specific cases or types of evidence that are no longer handled by the Illinois State Police Crime Lab. Examples of these types of cases and or evidence include, but are not limited to, the following: suicide cases, large evidence items exceeding 25 pounds, cases involving theft or burglary of items under $500, and syringes will no longer be accepted for evidence. The proposed contract with the Northern Illinois Regional Crime Lab will also allow for significantly faster turnaround time on the vast majority of evidence types when compared to the State of Illinois Crime Lab. Funds are budgeted and available in the current fiscal year for this program. This item was discussed at the June 14th, 2016 Public Safety Committee and recommended for approval.
This item is for first reading. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you. Item number 19, Trustee Panito.
I'd ask the board to consider adopting ordinance number 2016-0-033, amending chapter 154, title 15 of the Tinley Park Municipal Code regarding swimming pools.
May I have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Basically, this proposed ordinance makes changes to kind of eliminate conflicts with other sections of the code, as well as giving the village a clear code to enforce in dealing with related issues, including fence height, that's about it.
Okay, thank you. This item is up for adoption. Anybody on the board have any questions? Anybody from the public have any questions? Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Item 19 on final for ordinance 033 with roll call, Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Panito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yes.
Trustee Junker.
Yay.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 20, Trustee Panito.
Like to ask the board to consider adopting ordinance number 2016-0-034, amending chapter of title 11 of the Tinley Park Municipal Code governing general business license regulations. Basically, this amendment changes the dates that it's due to put it on a rolling schedule instead of everybody having to apply on January 1st, which causes problems for staff having to do them all at once.
May we have a second?
Second.
Any further discussion? Anybody from the board have any questions? This item is up for adoption. Anybody from the public care to comment? Seeing as there are none, Mr. Clerk.
Item 20 on final for ordinance 034 with roll call. Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Panito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yes.
Trustee Yonker.
Yay.
Trustee Suggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 21, Trustee Yonker.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like the board to consider resolution 2016-R-023 authorizing a real estate sale agreement with Intercontinental Real Estate Development Corporation and Odyssey I-80 LLC.
May we have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
The village has been in discussion with Intercontinental Real Estate Development Corporation for the purchase of two sets of properties for a roadway expansion project that will include intersection improvements at 191st Street and Harlem Avenue and extending 191st Street to Oak Park Avenue. The village is in receipt of a grant for this $6.6 million road extension with a leverage ratio of 5.7 to 1. Grant provides $5.70 for each village dollar. The first area of the property is for 0.949 acres needed to accommodate the curvature of the road off Harlem Avenue going east. The second area of land is a 1.71 acre piece that would connect 191st Street up to Oak Park Avenue. The negotiated prices for these two areas are $103,300 and $186,219 respectively for a total of $289,519. This item was discussed at Public Works Committee meeting held prior this evening. This resolution is for first reading.
So item is for first reading. All in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed?
Nay.
Motion carries. Thank you. Item number 22, Trustee Vandenberg.
Thank you. I'd ask the board to consider ordinance 2016-0-041, amending the village zoning ordinance section overlay district to establish a Rich Township Entertainment District overlay district.
May we have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. The purpose of this entertainment district is to attract, encourage tourism and entertainment uses. It allows the retention of an existing pylon sign, which is the old World Theater sign along 80 and Oak Park Avenue. And it restricts uses of the sign by business in the overlay district only. The Planning Commission did not recommend this for approval.
This item is up for first reading.
Anything else that you want to add to that, Paul? No? Thank you.
This item is up for first reading. All in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed?
No.
No.
Two opposed. Motion carries. Thank you. Item number 23, Trustee Yonker.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like the board to consider adopting resolution 2016-R-020 authorizing intergovernmental agreement by and between the Village of Tinley Park and the Metropolitan Water Reclamation District of Greater Chicago for construction and perpetual maintenance of stream bank stabilization of Midlothian Creek.
May we have a second, please?
So move.
This project is estimated at cost in excess of $400,000 and will be contracted paid for by the MWRD. In order to proceed with this project, MWRD requires an intergovernmental agreement with the village that outlines the project to be undertaken and provides the jurisdictional transfer of responsibility for the project improvements once they are completed. The area of Midlothian Creek runs through private property containing the Harper Hill Townhome Association. The Townhome Association provided necessary easements for the project in the project area. The project will have a 3-year growth and warranty period to assure the stabilization of vegetation is properly established. The Harper Hill Townhome Association and the village will also inspect the improvements prior to transfer of maintenance responsibilities at the end of the 3-year period. The village and the homeowners association have agreed to a memorandum of understanding regarding the project improvements and its future maintenance, which will be coordinated by the village and paid for by the Townhome Association. The village attorneys have reviewed the intergovernmental agreement and find it to be acceptable. This project and the intergovernmental agreement were discussed at the Public Works Committee meeting held on May 31st, 2016 and recommended for approval. This is eligible for adoption this evening.
Are there any members of the board that have any questions about this particular item? This item is up for adoption. Anybody from the public care to comment or have any questions? Yes, sir, please come up.
Just really quick, when you talked about the turnover part, who takes over the responsibility for that?
The ultimate responsibility for maintenance going forward?
Yeah, after the 3-year contract that you discussed. The village does?
The village, yeah.
Do you have a projected 10-year cost or 5-year cost on that?
It's paid for by the Townhome Association, isn't it?
Homeowners Association. Just curious, you know.
Yeah.
That would be the,
I didn't know what the
homeowners association is responsible for paying.
They're absorbing the cost for that?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Thank you for clarifying.
Any other questions from the public? Seeing as there are none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Item 23 on final for resolution 020. Roll call. Trustee Maher.
Yay.
Trustee Grady.
Yay.
Trustee Panito.
Yes.
Trustee Vandenberg.
Yes.
Trustee Junker.
Yes.
Trustee Scuggs.
Yes.
Motion carries. Item number 24, Trustee Suggs.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like the board to consider ordinance number 2016-0042, an ordinance designating the Village of Tinley Park Legacy Tax Increment Financing District.
May we have a second, please?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. On November 3rd, 2015, the Village of Tinley Park authorized moving forward with a feasibility study under the Tax Increment Finance TIF Act to determine if the area generally bounded by the railroad and Oak Forest Avenue on the north 175th place, 176th and 177th Street, on the south Cook County Forest Preserve, on the east and 66th Court, 67th Avenue and 67th Court, and on the west be designated as a redevelopment project area. This TIF is also referred to as the Panduit TIF, after the largest potential redevelopment site within the designated area. On February 16, 2016, the village announced the availability of the redevelopment plan and project for the proposed 217-acre Legacy TIF district. On April 22, 2016, the Legacy TIF District Joint Review Board met and gave a favorable recommendation of the redevelopment. And the project on June 7th, 2016, a public hearing for the Legacy TIF redevelopment plan and project was held. This ordinance would designate the redevelopment project area for the 217-acre as the Legacy Tax Increment Financing District redevelopment project. This ordinance is eligible for first reading.
Generally, we don't allow comment, but it looks like you have a comment to make, so we'll...
Oh, thank you. I'm not quite sure how it all works.
Well, it's usually for adoption that the public is invited to comment. This is just first reading. And
well, I don't even want it to get that far.
Well, wait
a minute.
Yeah, that's a nice answer.
Yeah. No, and this is the reason. At the TIF meeting, Mayor, you promised that you would have a gathering for all the residents to get together, discuss the TIF, to get to better understand it, and we haven't heard anything on that.
It was just actually the presentation was just finalized today. What we're going to do is reserve a half hour before the next board meeting, and it's basically going to be a TIF 101 class.
I don't think it should be part of a board meeting. I think it takes too much time. There's so many inconsistencies with this TIF that should not be going through. There's alternatives. There's nothing that you've looked at. I read your new FAQs, and I felt like I was being bullied. And I didn't appreciate it. And I don't think that we're being heard. As we said in the last meeting, nobody ever outright opposed you. But now you're shoving it down our throats. And I don't think it's right. I don't even think first reading should be occurring until we get a town hall meeting, till people understand it, to understand why you want us to put all this to help out the South and North Street TIF district without looking at other alternatives. And that's all I'm asking for, and I just wanted to get it on record.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This item has been moved and seconded. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Abstain.
Motion carries. Item number 25, a companion. The next two items are companion ordinances to this first one. Trustee Suggs.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like the board to consider ordinance number 2016-0043, an ordinance approved by the Village of Tinley Park Legacy Tax Increment Financing District Redevelopment Project Area.
May we have a second? Thank you.
Thank you. This is a companion ordinance to the previous agenda item regarding ordinance
number 2016-0042. This ordinance would approve the redevelopment plan and project for the 217-acre legacy tax increment financing district redevelopment plan and project. This ordinance is eligible for first reading.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed?
No.
Abstain.
Motion carries. Item number 26.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like the board to consider ordinance number 2016-0044, an ordinance adopting tax increment financing for the Village of Tinley Park Legacy Tax Increment Financing District.
May I have a second, please?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is a companion ordinance to the previous two agenda items regarding ordinance number 2016-0042 and 2016-0043. The tax increment financing district created by this ordinance would create an economic development tool to help the village in their redevelopment efforts of the former Panduit site and the surrounding redevelopment area and the installment of public improvements. This ordinance would approve tax increment financing for the Legacy Tax Increment Financing District. This ordinance is eligible for first reading.
First reading. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Abstain.
Abstain. Thank you. Motion carries. Item number 27, Trustee Suggs.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like the board to consider adopting ordinance number 2016-0026, establishing pay scale and certain fringe benefits for fiscal year 2017.
May I have a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Thank you. This ordinance establishes the pay scales and certain fringe benefits for non-collective bargaining village employees during the fiscal year beginning May 1st, 2016 and ending April 30th, 2017. This ordinance was discussed at the March 10th, 2016 Committee of the Whole meeting and was recommended for approval. This ordinance is eligible for adoption.
Since it is eligible for adoption, anybody on the board have any comment?
We're still moving forward.
This is just the scales. It's not changing anything other than the scales, right?
I'll defer.
Give us a little clarification of this, if you could. I don't remember March. I can't hear you. I couldn't hear you said.
It's the annual ordinance that basically changes the scales for non-union employees.
No. I think the question here is there any change from last year's scales?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course there is.
No. Yes, it's a 2.5 increase from the previous scales for non-union.
And where do we collect that number from?
Well, that was, if you remember, we did a survey of surrounding municipalities. We had discussed this and presented this at a COW meeting about a month and a half ago. And this is what we do every year. We do a comparable study of what the increases of some of our comparable towns are.
Yeah, this is in conjunction. I mean, this is preceding the studies that are being, I believe, RFP'd for the evaluation of salaries in general, which would be, those would have impact on the next year's salaries, not this one.
Correct. That's actually going to be a position by position review of where those positions stand relative to the market. So that's a much more comprehensive survey than the annual one we do every year where we just check what the wage scales are being increased by other towns.
I remember that.
Anybody have further questions?
I'm fine, Dave.
Thanks. You got it? Well, okay. This item is up for adoption. Anybody from the public care to comment?
Yeah. The 2.5% we're going to use because that's what the surrounding villages are doing. Can we implement the surrounding villages' pay before we worry about the 2.5%? Because
From what I've seen, they're actually lower.